Hello students, in the last class we have started with the chapter number 1, that is the concept of database. So we saw what was data, what is information, difference between data and information, then how can we process the particular data and convert it into information. Using an example, I explained how that particular data is converted to information and who are the users who use that particular data as data or as an information. So in the last class we also saw that the data and information varies from user to user. Also we saw what is a database, that is a collection of related data which are organized, recorded, okay, and made available for searching. Also we saw some of the properties of the database. Okay, hope the previous lecture, that is lecture number 2, is clear to all of you. If you haven't watched that particular video, kindly go to that lecture number 2 and view that, and then come to this lecture number 3. Here we will be learning about the traditional file system. So there are two basic things, that is traditional file system and database management system, for managing the files or the managing the data in a database. So during the previous times we used the traditional file system, but there are various disadvantages of using this particular file system, so we turned towards the new technique, that is the database management system. So let us go and look what this particular traditional file system is. The traditional file system we saw as in the previous diagram. I have given a diagram before the starting of this particular video, that is there were three basic blocks, okay, and in the first block it was on the sales department and the second block was your payroll department, okay, and in the sales department there is an application program, okay, and file number 1 is being created. Similarly in payroll department also there is a application program and file number 2 is generated using that application program. So what is the traditional file system? Traditional file system is that as the name suggests itself, that is it is basically dependent on files and folders. Example we can take of the operating system, Windows operating system. How we are working on it? We are working on the files and folders. Okay, so this is the way of storing data using files and folders. Okay, so this is the basic thing that you have to know, that what is a traditional file system. Traditional file system is using the data or storage of the data for a particular reason in the form of files and folders. Example, as I told you, that is your operating system. In operating system that you can see all your files and folder, all the data is stored in the form of files and folders. C drive, in C drive you double click it, then there is folder in any particular, suppose where there is a video folder, name of the folder is video. Inside that particular folder when you go, there are files. Files means any n number of video files can be there. Okay, so this is the basic technique used to store the data in file system. Okay, but there are various disadvantages of using this particular file system. So we had to move towards using a new technique, that is database management system. So before going towards database management system, let us see one by one what the disadvantage of using this traditional file system. So in the upcoming slides, I would like to show you what are the disadvantages, and one by one I will explain you each and every point by using a particular real life example. Okay, the next topic is disadvantages of the traditional file system. So there are various disadvantages of traditional file system. Point by point, let us go through it. The first disadvantage is data redundancy. Redundancy, as the word suggests, it means that it is the duplicate copies, means creation of duplicate copies of data at different locations. For understanding this more clearly, let us take an example. Suppose I am taking the example of a school and a teacher. So for a teacher in a school, there will be basically two departments. One is a office department and other is the payroll or the accounts department. So what the office department store? The office department stores the location, the address, the information, overall details of a teacher. Whereas what does the accounts department store? The account department will store the details of payment of the particular employee or the teacher. That what is the basic salary of the teacher, what is the PF that has to be deducted, then what is the DA that has to be given. All these things will be reflected in the payroll department. Now what happens in redundancy is that the office department will be storing all my details, that is my name, my address, Aadhaar number, date of birth, everything. The payroll department also has to do the same job. He also has to first add my address, my name, my date of birth, Aadhaar number, everything. And then a new field has to be added, that is what will be my payment, what is the basic, what is PF, what is DA of that particular employee. Okay, so in both this department, what is common? The common is the employee detail. So we can see that the duplicate copies are being created here, that is the information of the employee. So this reduces the memory space, as well as this reduces the efficiency also and increases the time. Hope that data redundancy is clear to you. Okay, so the next disadvantage is data inconsistency. What do you mean by data inconsistency? Data inconsistency is somewhat related to data redundancy only. That is, the data should be updated at all locations. Wherever the data is stored, it should be updated in all that particular location in case of the traditional file system, as we have to create duplicate copies at two different locations. So if any particular location we are changing the data, that change should be reflected in all the other locations. So that is one of the major disadvantages of using this traditional file system. Let us take the same example of the teacher and school. The teacher has two departments, as I told you. The first is the office department and the second is the accounts department. In the office department, the teacher has his or her all details, personal details, and in the payroll department or the accounts department, he or she has his personal details as well as the salary details. So if the teacher changes his address. That is, suppose I am staying at sector 4. Now I move to some other location. Now I am shifting my location from sector 4 to CLASS. So I informed the office. Now the office has changed my address. But the office person did not inform the account section. So what happens? In my office details, the address is CLASS, and at the accounts department section, my address is still sector 4. So which is inconsistent. Okay, a person cannot be at two different locations at the same time, the same person. So that is inconsistency situation or inconsistent situation. So whenever a particular data is updated at a particular location, it has to be updated in all other locations, because there was a condition of data redundancy, that is the data is stored at different location. So when a particular data is changed at one of the location, it has to be changed in all the other locations also. So this is the other major disadvantage of using the traditional file system. Now, as we have seen two disadvantages, that is data redundancy and data inconsistency. The next problem that occurs in traditional file system is the lack of data integration. Now, what is the meaning of data integration? Data integration means, as the name is saying here, we can see what is the point that is written here is setting up the constraints. Setting of constraints means some limitations. In case of file system, we cannot set a particular constraint to a given data. Let us take an example of a banking system. In banks, we know that when we create a particular account, now according to the new rules, there should be any particular balance that has to be kept in the account, or else fine is imposed. Okay, we have to have that particular amount of balance in our account, or else if that account balance is not maintained, then what happens is that there can be termination of the account also. So 1000 rupees for a particular city is the constraint of the account balance of a citizen. So we have to set the constraint to be 1000 rupees account balance for that particular banking system database. But in case of file system, it is a problem. We are unable to set any kind of constraint on any of the datas of that particular database. But in case of DBMS only, we can do it. That is, by using DBMS, we can set constraint for particular attributes of the data, of the datas in a database. Okay, so simply you should know that what is data integration. Data integration is the process of setting constraints for the attributes of a data in a database. Example, real life example, you take that in a banking system, the account balance is one of the attribute. That attribute should have a limit. That is, 1000 rupees is the constraint. Minimum constraint is 1000. So we have to maintain that 1000 rupees in our account. So we have to set that constraint of that particular attribute, that is account balance, as 1000. So that if any entry comes which is below 1000 rupees in the beginning, okay, that is while creation of that account, it won't accept it. We have to put a minimum balance of 1000 rupees at the start, and after that we cannot make it as zero also. It should be 1000. Okay, so that is called as data integration. But in case of file system, it is not possible to maintain the, or we cannot set the constraint. So this leads to lack of data integration. Next is atomicity problem. Atomicity, what is the meaning of this? It means that the transaction process, the transaction should either be totally complete or it should fail. It should not be somewhat at the center position. For example, let us take where all of you must be using the phone pay or Paytm, etc. So while we are doing any sort of transaction, that we suppose I am transferring some particular amount to another account. So what happens at the time of processing? The processing takes place and then a message comes, that is transaction successful. This much is the balance, this is your transaction ID, this is your UID, etc. Or else what happens is that transaction cannot be completed, transaction failed, transaction failure IDs is this. So this things comes, the error message comes and the transaction is failed. So this is possible in case of DBMS only. In case of file system, there is a problem of atomicity. That is, it might be possible that the transaction is complete, but the user does not come to know that either the transaction complete or whether it is finished or whether it is failed. It might be a possibility that somewhere it is at the in the state of uncertainty. The user cannot come to know whether it is failed or whether it is successful. So this occurs in case of file system, but in case of DBMS it is not so. Okay, so these two are another disadvantages of the traditional file system. Now coming to the next disadvantage of the traditional file system, the first here is the security issues. There are various security issues in traditional file system, that is giving permission to the users. For example, let us take the database of a school. So that database should have different views. Views means what? If suppose I am a teacher, I should get a different view of that particular database. The principal of the school should get a different view of that particular database. The student of a school should have another view of the database. Also, in place of view also, a teacher should have a different accessibility of that database, and the student should have a different access, and the principal should have another access to the same database. But this is not possible in case of traditional file system. There are various security issues. What happens is that in giving permissions means, suppose I am a teacher, now what is my access or what is my permission? My permission is that I can view the marks of a particular student. I can also change the mark of a particular student. Okay, now what are the other things? Other thing is that I can only view the mark of IT subject of class 11 and 12, because I am teaching only class 11 and 12, and which subject? Only information technology. So my permission is that I can just view the marks of the particular student of information technology of the classes 11 and 12 as a subject teacher. If I am a class teacher, then possibly I can have the permission to view the marks of all the subjects, but I cannot edit it. Okay, so this is the permission. You are the student. You can view your own attendance. You can view the assignments given to you. You can give, you can view the marks of yourself, okay, but you cannot change the mark, okay, you cannot change the assignments given to you, the parents portal that you have got, okay, you just log in using your user ID and password. Whatever is your attendance, that is visible to you. The marks that you got in all the subjects is visible to you, okay. You cannot view the attendance of any other friend of your until and unless you got you get his or her password, okay. So that is the security given in database management system, but it is not possible in traditional file system. We can make it secure, but there are various issues. Much more security is in DBMS as compared to this flat file system. The next issue is the concurrent access. Concurrent access means accessing the same database by many users at the same time. So if we are using the file system, this is a very big issue. That is, many people will access the database. If suppose many people are accessing a particular database at the same time, then that will create a havoc situation to the database. It will put in a lot of load to that particular database. Okay, so concurrency control is not there in case of flat file system or the traditional file system. You can take the example of the Tatkal rail ticket booking. That is a DBMS system. You can see that as soon as there is a particular slot of time when the Tatkal reservation time starts, and within 2 to 3 minutes you can see that all the seats have been booked. Okay, so you won't find that a particular in case of DBMS, you won't find that the same seat is allocated to two persons. It is not so. Okay, a confirmed seat cannot be given to two persons in the railway management system. It is not possible in case of DBMS, but there can be a possibility of errors in case of traditional file system, as concurrent access is not possible here. The third disadvantage is data isolation. Data isolation means, as the name suggests, data should be separated from users or the application programs. But in case of the traditional file system, the user and the data both are linked, as you can see at the top. In the beginning, there was a diagram of sales department, payroll department. You can see how the file 1 is attached to the department and file 2 attached to the department. So there is no basic isolation between the data and the user. So this is another security issue. That is, the data might get corrupted, or the data can be changed by the user or the application programs. And the if such a situation arises, that can cause a very big security issues in a very big database system. Okay, so these are the basic 7 points of the disadvantages of traditional file system. First was redundancy problem, inconsistency, then lack of integration, atomicity problem, security, concurrent access, and data isolation. So due to these disadvantage of the file system, we had to move towards the database management system.